Assistive technology aims to improve the lives of people living with disabilities. In the simulation and visualization program, we ask students in the Portfolio 6 course to put their hardware and software skills to use towards a positive cause. The idea is, if anybody struggles with daily activities, what can we do to try and help them? And it's also partly just looking into the community instead of trying to, you know, come up with some epic project, just looking down the street and see what's around here so we can participate in the local community. CECO is a facility down the street here that works with kids with cerebral palsy and a whole range of motor disabilities and things like that.
It's so important for me to give success for these kids because they lose it in very early ages. Started with like, I cannot roll over, I cannot reach for my toy, but I want to. But I think we can change their life and make them as independent in their own life as possible.
Their facility has lots of ladder devices like this because they use them for strength training and grip, climbing, walking. So when we toured their facility and realized that, we decided that's a good target. Let's see if we can try to digitize one of these and make it interactive.
It still works nice.
We gave the audio version to them just to play around with and see what they thought about it. And that alone had fantastic results. What they told us was a lot of these kids have trouble even lifting their neck. But when they were reaching up and pressing on it and it was making a sound, they were looking up to see what was going on. And that was a huge, huge win for the staff over there. They were very excited to see that. But once we got past the audio version, we put on a monitor and a little computer. So now we could do software development and start making games and tie it into our inputs. And that's where the potential just went through the roof. The students were involved in every aspect of it. In fact, we were doing things that I had never done, so it was new to all of us, a lot of it.
Some of the challenges that we faced when constructing it were some electrical issues. We had some issues with the wiring and the paint methods to detect if people were touching it. We got some false triggers, which was a real challenge.
Even putting our hand near it, it was triggering false positives, and that was no good. Once we got past that, it was not too many challenges and just a lot of fun.
They started out very simple. They would grab a piece of the ladder and the screen would change colors. And then as soon as we got that down, we started coming up with a lot of other different ideas. And then from there, once we got some feedback from CECO to say, you know, this is good, or, you know, maybe this isn't very good, we just went from there and eventually just built those blocks up until we had something that both of us were really proud of.
This is something that some of my students and I have been working on for many months. And we made it to obviously look very similar to some of the devices you have here, these ladders. And we looked at some of the activities that you do and tried to make them into more like a game, a computer version where we can interact and get feedback. So does anybody want to try this out?
It's so important for our kids to like get the technology closer to them because it's motivating them more. Almost all of our kids has an iPad at home. Now they have the motivation right in front of them. It gives us opportunity to develop head control, develop eye-hand coordination, develop holding grasp, and it's connected with a game which contains the opportunity to develop cognitive levels as well.
After we delivered the ladder, I got back and we started receiving pictures of the kids and the staff using it. And that's when it really kicked in. The smiles were so powerful.
A lot of the projects I had worked on previously usually involved some sort of training. It was really nice to see that there's just a totally different direction that the field can go.
Sometimes we just lose touch with connecting with people and helping out each other. And it's just like, do you need a helping hand? We can just help you with this stuff, make your life a little bit better.
For us, it was just work. But when you see the result of that and the smiles, that's when you realize you've done something much bigger than just worked on a project.
Yeah.